Hello everyone, thank you so very much for joining me for another episode of Screw the Cubicle TV. I'm Lydia Lee, the Corporate Escape Coach at Screw the Cubicle, and you're in the right place if you've been looking for ways to reinvent your life and your career, to be out of the traditional 9-to-5 and figure out ways to actually be utilizing your talents and your skills to launch a business or a new freelance career. So today I want to talk about a topic that I know trumps a lot of people when they are first-time business owners, which is how to build your expertise without relying on a history of a business or thinking that you don't have anything to offer right away because you haven't gotten your first client. This is definitely my fear when I was launching my first ever business, and it definitely is probably something you're going through right now. However, I want to give you that permission to go after that business you love to create and the work that you want to do, and that actually you already have the experience that exists within your life and your professional life that we just need to focus on and bring that into the attention of your focus so that you feel confident and competent to actually help in a business or your freelance career without being tied to a job. Okay, so waiting for this perfect time to start a business because of the fact that you haven't had a first client is sort of a backwards way of looking at it. To get to our first client, we have to be there for other people and be of service first before we can even dream about attracting an ideal client to our vicinity. So I want to talk about the three ways today of how you can build credibility and expertise when you first start your new business. Okay, so the first thing to look at when it comes to proving your credibility and expertise, even if you're doing a business idea or a different type of work that may have nothing to do with your past resume. The first point I want to make is that actually what you've learned to do in an accumulated experience in your professional resume is actually very, very important to highlight again in the new work that you're choosing to do. Just because you're in a different role, just because you might be solving different problems, or right now you're doing a business or a job that isn't very much a part of the history of your resume, there are still strengths and skills that you're bringing forward, almost repurposing them, right, into this new role that is actually very credible to your expertise. So for example, if you have skill sets like being a people person or being a compassionate human being or being a great listener or being very organized in your projects for your clients, that is a very likely a skill set or a strength that can be brought forward to this new role that you're doing. So your credibility isn't always just about doing the job itself, like the obvious thing. You know, for example, let's say if you decide to be a web designer right now because you've been learning web designing on the side and you really love it, but you've actually never done it professionally before. What are the sort of strengths and skills that you actually have done that you think you'd be bringing forward to the relationships that you're going to currently have with your web design clients? A lot of it could be that you are a great storyteller, right? Or you may be a great listener to the brand story that they have, and being able to translate that to a vision for their business, which is now being a web design or a website that they get, but actually the process of how you get people to that end result for your business is actually the strengths and skills that are not the obvious kind, right, which is web designing. But what it is the how you manage those relationships, how you make it easy for them to be envisioning their website, how you're going to be tailoring the design and concepts of their website towards their story. You know, all those things are actually really strong points to make when you're taking on even your first clients, to be highlighting why that's a good reason to hire you. So looking at these skills and strengths that can be repurposed towards your new career is a great first start, right? Take a look at the things that people used to say to you that you were really good at in your past jobs. What is the common theme, you know, of how people say that you are most helpful, most valuable, and what they feel is the most important part about working with you? And how can you bring those qualities into your new role and actually talking a lot about that in your process versus actually talking about just the goal or the end result that your business does? The second way of building your credibility and expertise as a first-time business owners is to show value at the start of time. So even if you don't have a website right now and you're working on it, this is not a waiting game for you to be of value. You don't have to wait for your website for you to actually be starting to help people. So the concept of this is being able to be of service and teach people what you know, even before they sign up to be your client, or even when you have a blog or a website started yet. It doesn't actually matter. There's sort of a lot of ways to do this and be helpful even before you have a big asset like your website available. Because the whole point of credibility and expertise building is showing your work, right? Showing what you're capable of and showing the style of how you help. And practicing that is actually so beneficial for you as a business owner, so that you can actually be working with real humans and diagnosing people's problems even before they say, I'm going to be your client. And that practice is absolutely going to help you when you do have a client that you're going to be working on that you do charge for. So some examples of showing your work and teaching is going into things like Facebook groups that you belong to, right? So if you're not belonging to a Facebook group, search for Facebook groups that hold the ideal clients that you think will very likely be a best suit for you. So if you work with solopreneurs or mothers or millennials, whoever is that demographic that you work with, try to get into the groups where you share common interest for something big, whether it's an interest for business, an interest for travel, an interest for sewing. Whatever is your industry, get into these groups and actually be in front of an audience when you don't have a list built yourself just yet, which is an awesome way to jump on a group and be in front of that audience and start sharing information. Introduce yourself in the group, talk about what you can help with, search the group using the search bar in the group to look for topics and keywords that you know you can respond to and comment on, even if they're past conversations in that group. What that really shows is that you are proving your expertise by replying, right, and helping along the way. You can even post a new post and actually talk about what's the number one struggle that people have when it comes to, you know, this problem that you want to be solving, and get people to tell you what their problems are and actually coach them, mentor them, consult with them through that thread in that practice of helping people. You could even use Facebook in a different manner. So don't forget that your inner circle, your network of people that are in your Facebook right now could be potential clients for you. So jumping on a live stream or a video or just writing a short post that has some advice on it, again, helps you position your advice towards this topic that you want to be known for. All it is about practicing delivering value, delivering great content, and delivering help to people that need you. And in time, as you do a lot more of this efficiently and weekly, people are going to start to recognize you for your abilities. The third way of how you can build credibility for your expertise as a new business owner is to not forget to share your story. A lot of you might be starting a business that actually comes from a personal struggle and a personal pain that you've gone through as a human, and now you feel called to help someone else going through that problem, right? You're a little bit ahead, a couple grades ahead of your ideal customer. And so a really great way to really look, tell people that you are the person to help them with this is because you've gone through what they've gone through. So storytelling and being open actually about your own journey of how you went through those hurdles, how you went through all those painful moments in your life and coming out of it actually knowing a lot more than you ever did. And you want to save them that time, that effort to go through that same hurdle themselves. And that's why you're here, right? You're shortcutting them to the goals and the achievements that they should be having without going through all that muddiness and lostness that you may have felt going through it. So that personal story is absolutely so important. A lot of us disregard our life experience. If it's not on our resume, we sort of feel, oh, you know, we shouldn't talk about it. But actually, what you've gone through as a human, you know, all the bravery that you may have discovered within yourself when you went through some pain, the answers that you researched and gone through and tested, failed again and started again, all those stories are actually really key in allowing people to, first of all, resonate with you, that you understand the state that they're in and the confusion they're in. And the fact that you've gone through it personally, whether you've been paid to do it or not, or just something that happened in your life, is actually super, super credible for you. I am someone that will absolutely hire someone that has an emotional reason to do the work that they do. They've gone through the same pain I'm currently going through and can sort of help me see the forest from the trees, rather than just the credentials of what certifications they have or university degrees they have. That's almost secondary for me when I hire a human to help me with something. We want to connect with another human. So find ways to tell your story. Find ways to tell people what you've discovered in your own journey as a way of not only bonding with potential customers that are watching that video or reading that blog that you write about the story, but it also allows them to really see the journey that they can too take with you that will be a lot faster, that could be a lot clearer than doing it themselves. So storytelling is such a big priority for you in order to gain that credibility and build resonance with your ideal customers. All right, gang, so your mission for the day is to take a 20-minute pause, take out a pad of paper, or actually download the worksheet that I'm including with this video called Show Your Work, in order to prompt you to remember all the strengths and skill sets and experience that you actually do bring to the table, even as a new business owner. All you have to do is to be reminded of actually your professional and your life experiences that actually really is good evidence that you are the person to go to for even this new business that you are starting right now. So download that worksheet called Show Your Work in order to be prompted into realizing what is the credibility that you bring to the table. And taking this 20 minutes is so essential, because I think once you understand what it is that you should be talking about and how to talk about your work and how to be depending on what has already happened in your life and what skill sets you come with, it's so important to build that new confidence when it comes to being a new business owner. Because one of the big things you'll be doing when you launch your business is to be talking about yourself and talking about why you're credible and why this work really matters to you. So start getting practice by doing this worksheet, knowing it yourself first, and then thinking of ways that you can produce this externally for other people. So I talked a little bit about live streaming as a way of positioning yourself in your expertise. I talked about going into Facebook groups to help out people that are suffering with that problem that you know how to help with, and actually engaging with them and helping them authentically without expecting anything back. And I guarantee you, people will start asking in due time what it is that you do. If you have a blog, if you have a YouTube channel just like this, is it a platform that you can actually be filming a video or writing a blog post about that actually showcases your expertise and credibility, or the storytelling bit of your life journey to allow that resonance and connection that you want to have with your audience? So I would love to hear from you which three parts of this expertise building tips for this video that you would like to implement today, and how will you implement that to be accountable for that this week? Please do let me know. I would love for you to share. Thank you so much once again for joining me for another episode of Screw the Cubicle TV. As always, everything that I do and I film and I teach is for you. So please comment below and let me know any topics that you would like for me to film, and I will make sure to do so and credit you for the question that you asked. Thank you so very much, and enjoy the rest of your day and night. See you later. Hey, thank you so very much for watching Screw the Cubicle TV, and don't forget to subscribe below to get all the latest cubicle crashing content on how to quit your 9-to-5 and create a life and business on your own terms.